we've been doing a house concert series that started in the fall. We're going to continue it on because we're really having the best time with it. At one of the concerts, George Francois, who taught for 3 years at UVA, came back to visit, and he invited his dear friend Rita Dove to come. And during intermission, the two of them were doodling at the piano and singing, and they opened the second set. And I thought, oh, wouldn't that make a great concert? So I asked if they would do that, and they both graciously agreed to do that. Rita, I think, is no stranger to you all. She is a world-renowned poet. We are blessed to have her in our community in Virginia. She's won numerous awards, but she also loves to sing. And I think you're going to see how wonderful she is at doing that tonight. George, I met very, very briefly when he lived here. He doesn't even remember, but we said hi backstage because Lisa introduced us. And I've gotten to know him over the last year and a half. He's an incredible pianist, world-renowned also, and he has a nonprofit called Sankusem, and Rita graciously agreed to let us charge admission and have that money go to George's nonprofit, which he will tell us about later. And one of the reasons I did that is if you don't know the format of house concerts, you cannot charge, you can only ask for donations. And when I sent out the email about this concert, everybody I knew sent back an email saying I'm coming, and I was panicked at the thought about 200 people trying to get in here. So this was a wonderful way to help out George's nonprofit, to get people who really wanted to come, and to ensure that we would have a great evening. I think we're going to have an awful lot of fun. They're going to do 3 sets. I think you'll know when each set ends. So in between, we'll have a brief intermission. There is a lot of dessert left. Previously, we've had too many dishes, no dessert, too much wine, no dessert. Tonight, we have more dessert than you should eat. But do eat it. My husband and I are gluten-free, dairy-free, so there is nothing there that we want. I have made my entire staff but one gluten-free, dairy-free. I cannot give it to them. So feel free to eat, take home little doggy bags, do whatever you want. That'll be just an extra treat. George, is there anything? Oh, we are not allowing any photos or videoing tonight. I know at some of the concerts people have done that, and I think we're going to start limiting that at concerts. And at this one, Fred is going to be filming for Rita, and we're hoping some of that will be posted on YouTube. And I guess they'll let us know if it is. If you're not on my email list, please sign it. And I really think you really didn't come to hear me talk, so that's it for me. Rita Dove is going to come out and entertain us. Let's give a big hand for Rita.
I need some coffee. It is what I cannot start anything without coffee, and it has to be black coffee. You know, I don't like any of these cappuccinos and frappes and lattes and all those things that mess up the pure, dark, rich taste of that coffee bean. And since I'm a poet and I talk in metaphor, you know what I mean, right? I'm feeling mighty lonesome, haven't slept a wink. I walk the floor and watch the door, and in between I drink black coffee. Love's a hand-me-down brew. One o'clock to cigarettes. I'm moving all the morning and I'm moaning all the night. And in between there's nicotine and not much will to fight black coffee. Feeling low as the ground. You know, I've posed for pictures with ivory soap. I've petted stray dogs and I've steered clear of dope. My smile is, well, we'll talk about that later. My smile is brilliant, my glance is tender, but I'm most noted for my unspoiled gender. I've been made Miss Rheingold twice, though I never taste beer. And people say to me, you're sweet, my dear. The only etchings I've seen are behind glass. The closest I've been to a bar in the last 10 minutes, 30 minutes, a ballet class. Prim and proper. I'm a girl who's never been kissed, but I'm tired of being pure. I'm pissed. Champagne. find the very mention of you like a kicker in a julep or two. The thrill of the thought that you might give a thought to my plea cast a spell over me. Like a summer with a thousand Julys, you intoxicate my soul with your eyes. Though I'm certain that this heart of mine hasn't a ghost of a chance in this crazy romance.
Making this up.
My life was dull each minute until I found you in it. And then the happiness I knew was filled with dreams of loving you. I think it's time to pull my husband out for a rumble.
Choice.
We have no choice. It's a perfect rumba.
Marry me, no. not marry me. Rectangular is the hotel door my true love tried to sneak through. Rectangular is the window pane that I had to peek through. Rectangular is the hotel room I entered angrily. And rectangular is the wooden box where my true love lies neath the golden flux. They said he died of the chicken pox. To that I might agree. One chick too many had he. Triangular is the piece of pie I eat to ease my sorrow.
I can enjoy that piece of pie. I'm eating my pie. I'm gonna sing that line. I'm gonna start that verse again because I like my pie.
Triangular is a piece of pie I eat to ease my sorrow. Triangular is the hatchet blade I plan to hide tomorrow. Triangular, the relationship that now has ceased to be. And triangular is the garment thin that I fasten with two safety pins to a prize I had no wish to win. It's a lasting memory that my true love gave to me. This afternoon, actually new. I'll tell you a little bit about it while we're getting warmed up. It's from a Kurt Weill musical that really didn't make it, but in it, Venus comes down to Earth, and she's changed into a woman, and she falls in love, and she can't seem to make this guy notice her. What an idiot. Okay.
Yeah. I know.
It's called I'm a Stranger to Myself. Is love just a popular suggestion or merely an obsolete art? Forgive me for asking this simple question. I'm unfamiliar with his heart. I am a stranger here myself. Why is it wrong to murmur I adore him when it's shamefully obvious I do? Does love embarrass him or does it bore him? I'm unfamiliar with his clues. I am a stranger here myself. Oh, I yearn for the day. It's a gay, warm day with my face between his hands. Have I missed the bat? Have I gone astray? I ask, but no one understands. Love me or leave me, that seems to be the question. I don't know the tactics to use. But if he should offer a personal suggestion, how could I possibly refuse when I'm a stranger myself? Please tell me, tell a stranger, my personality goaded. Is there really any danger that love is outmoded? I'm interested especially in knowing why you wasted. True romance is so fleshly, but what have you replaced it? What is your latest foible? Is it running more exquisite? Is he more enjoyable? For heaven's sakes, what is it?
Yeah, when I get that.
What's the next word? Thank you. I can't believe that love has lost its glamour, that passion is really passé. If gender is just a term in grammar. How can I ever go astray? I'm a stranger here myself. How can he ignore my available condition? Why, his Victorian views. You see here before you a woman with a mission. I must discover the key to his ignition. And then if he should make a diplomatic proposition, how could I possibly refuse? When I'm a stranger here
myself. Got anything you're gonna do before I introduce Miss Rita? You
tell us about that.
No, he's gonna tell you that between the second and third set, or after the third set, you'll tell us about Sankusem. They have an order. These people are very professional. They have an order. They have rehearsed all week. They've spent the. And how many hours do you think you put into rehearsing this week?
Well, I came in the morning Tuesday night.
Tuesday night from 8 till 3 a.m. 2 a.m.
3 a.m.
3 a.m. Wednesday night from.
About 3 hours in the afternoon and about 4 hours.
Another 7 hours, and then today we had rehearsal?
Yes. We walked through.
They walked. So after the concert, if they look at you a little bleary-eyed, they'll know why. All right, well, I'm gonna leave it to you all. Shall I introduce the lady of the evening?
Yeah.
We're hoping that out of that back room will come Rita Dove. What do you think? Give her a hand, and here she comes.
They rush you. I'm here. I see you're all very convivial. You have your drinks there. I see a lot of wine. You know, there's only one drink in the world that's worth its salt, and that is this little number here. Vodka is the tautological extreme of alcohol consumption, because it is absolutely clear and pure, comes straight from the earth. It has no pretenses, no flavors or anything like that. It is just it. It's kind of a lovely drink. What can I say? Of all concoctions, alcoholical, there is but one that's diabolical. I simply thrive on old champagne and sparkling burgundy. I like that. Shut up. Whiskey, Cointreau, Moselle, and Eau de Vie are just like tea. But vodka, don't give me vodka, 'cause when I take a little drink, I forget to think what a little drink can do to me. Vodka, don't give me vodka, 'cause when I take a little sip, I begin to slip, and I start romancing with the gal that I'm dancing with. Ooh, you're looking very nice. Vodka makes me feel odd, and I will grab a 5'2". Any girl will do, long as she is wise enough to see. It's a chaperone. I won't scream, should she kiss me couldn't if I could, couldn't if I would. Vodka, you ruined me. I have to take a little sip, you know. Don't tell my mother. Everyone has their drink. George, what is your drink?
Whiskey.
Whiskey? That stuff is wood. It's made of wood. I mean, you sit there and you age it in wood, it tastes like eggs. And gin is full of perfume. There's only one. It is this one. It is clear. You can taste the grain that it's made out of. And anyone else? Dear. Thank you, honey. I'll come get you later. Okay. It is, when you drink this, it goes straight down in one searing path, all the way to your little toe. Oh, shut up, George. It's not that bad. I'll put the lid on. Vodka, please give me vodka, 'cause when I take a little drink, I forget to think what a little drink can do to me. Vodka, please give me vodka, 'cause when I take a little sip, I begin to slip, and I start romancing with the gal that I am dancing with. You are something else. Vodka. My darling vodka. And then I'll grab a fight for two. Gal, a guy will do. Long as they are wise enough to see. I won't scream should she kiss me. I really won't. I might give a little whimp. Couldn't if I should. Vodka, you ruined me.
Thank you.
George, I just met the love of my life.
Rita, I thought I was the love of your life.
Well, you are the love, you'll always be the love of my life, but this is different. This is like Clara and Robert. He is my Clara.
He?
He.
It's a hair?
Kinda, yeah. But gender does not matter when it comes to true love. I you could call him a frau hair, maybe.
Because you are a hair.
Of course. Okay. Of course. Okay. What do you imply?
And so you are Robert.
I am Robert.
And this person.
This person is Clara. You know, Robert so loved Clara.
You're talking about the Schumann.
Yes, I'm talking about Robert and Clara Schumann. They so loved each other that, you know, he wrote such beautiful things to her.
He wrote the poem.
No, he didn't write the poem. He wrote the music to the poem. The poem was called Dedication, and he loved her.
There's a poem called Dedication.
Yes.
Written by...
The poet's name is Rückert, and it really is the love poem of the
and
century.
And you're saying that you are the Robert to this Frau Herr's Clara.
Yes, I am. We are bound together for eternity. I could feel it. I could feel the way he looked at me. I could feel the way he kind of was drawn into my eyes.
But Robert and Clara, didn't they have Brahms in between them?
Well, yes, it was true.
Didn't Robert end up dead in an asylum or something?
Yeah, that had nothing to do with, I mean, well, that was, well, it might have been because of love. He had syphilis then. He kept hearing an A, that one, yes, over and over in his head, which could drive anybody mad. But and yes, Brahms did seduce Clara once,
yes.
But their love prevailed, and my love would never do that to me.
So you want to talk about
I want to read that poem. Do you have it there?
I have some poem.
I put it there for you. this poem, I'm going to read it in German. You just listen. Okay.
In German.
It was written in German, that's why. And because if you listen to the words, you can feel how soft and gentle they are. So it's called Widmung. Du meine Seele, du mein Herz, du meine Wonne, du mein Schmerz. Du meine Welt, in der ich lebe, mein Himmel, du dahin ich schwebe. O du mein Grab, in das hinab ich ewig mein Kummer gab.
I heard a grab in there. You mean like grab, like you were grabbing the Frau Herr, you know, doing your...
Grab? Like I was... No. That wasn't...
So
and I wasn't grabbing my Frau Herr. He was in my arms. Okay, you could see how he loved me, right? Okay, anyway. No, the grab in there is grab, which means grave, but it isn't morbid. The English is sort of, you my soul, you my heart, oh, you my bliss, oh, you my pain, you the world in which I live, you my heaven in which I float, oh, you my grave, that probably was Brahms. Oh, you my grave, into which eternally I cast my grief. So he was casting his sorrow into the grave. He just meant that Clara was everything to him, joy, pain.
So you are going to sing this song that Robert wrote?
Oh, no, I'm not going to sing it. I want you to play it.
You want me to play it?
Yes, the music, because Schumann, it's such a beautiful piece of music. Would you play that?
There is a Liszt transcription of that song,
okay,
which I could play.
Please, we're wanting to play it, right? Yeah. So play it for these people while I slip into something more comfortable.
Thank you. That I
end up this way. Now I never go to shows at night, but just to matinee. I see the show and home I go. Once I left when I heard you say that I'd be playing solitaire, uneasy in my easy chair. It never entered my mind. Once you told me I was mistaken and I would waken with the sun and order orange juice for one. It never entered my says a good man is hard to find. Absolutely, positively must be blind. I got the best man there ever was. There's some of the things he does. He shakes my ashes, greases my griddle, churns my butter, tunes my fiddle. Thank God I got my handyman. He threads my needle, creams my wheat. You should see how he tenderizes my meat. My man is such a handyman. Such a handyman. He slaps my flapjacks, clears off the table, feeds the horses in my stable. My man is such a handyman. He is up way before dawn, a busy trimming the rough edges on a mine. My man is such a handyman. He never has a word to say, not when he's working hard. And you should just see the way he handles my front yard.
While we were waiting for you all to show up this evening, George played piano for us about a half hour. That was really quite delightful as we were cleaning and cooking up. Anyway, we're ready for our third set, so without further ado, the diva, Rita Dove.
Try to think that love's not around. Still, it's uncomfortably near. My old heart ain't gaining no ground because my angel eyes ain't here. Angel eyes, that old devil scent, they glow impossibly bright. My whole life has now been misspent with angel eyes tonight. So drink and the laughs on me. Pardon me, but I've gotta run. The facts uncommonly clean. Gotta find out who's now number one and why my angel eyes ain't here.
Was too plebeian, said that he was through with me and
all know that the men will say that they're sorry, and they may even drop a few artful tears here and there. And they might take us out, treat us real nice, but we know there's only one thing they really want, right? I'm gonna sing this rock, gut, blues for ya. Are you ready, George? You're always ready. Don't you feel my leg? Don't you feel my leg? Oh, don't you feel my leg? You wanna feel my thigh. And if you feel my thigh, you wanna go up high. So don't you feel my leg? Oh, don't you buy no wine? Don't you buy no wine? 'Cause if you buy some wine, you'll try to change my mind. And if you change my mind, you don't want this fine behind. So don't you buy my wine. I told you it's wrong. He takes me out and you treat me fine, but I know there's something lurking in your mind. Get drunk and you try to get fresh, then you start begging for this fine brown flesh. So don't you dare touch my leg, baby. Don't you touch my leg, 'cause if you touch my leg, you'll wanna touch my thigh. And if you touch my thigh, you'll wanna go high. So don't you touch my leg. I guess it gets its point across. This next one gets its point across too. It's another Kurt Vile song.
Pirate James, right?
Well, you gentlemen can look as I'm scrubbing the floors. And I'm scrubbing the floors while you're gawking. You toss me a tip, and it makes me feel swell in this crummy southern town in this crummy old hotel. But you'll never guess to whom you're talking. No, you'll never guess to whom you're talking. Then in the night, there's a scream in the night, and you say, who could that have been? And you see me kind of grinning as I'm scrubbing, and you ask, what you got to grin? I'll tell ya. There's a ship, the Black Freighter, with a skull on its mast, will be coming in. Well, you say, hey gal, finish them floors, mind your keep. What's wrong with you? Mind your keep here. And you pocket your tips as you look at the ships, but I'm counting the heads as I'm making the beds, 'cause nobody gonna sleep here tonight. No, nobody's gonna sleep here tonight. Then in the night, there's a scream in the night, and you say, who's that kicking up a row? And you see me kind of looking out the window, and you say, what you got to look at now? I tell you, there's a ship, the Black Freighter, turns around in the harbor, shooting guns on its bow. Well, you gentlemen can wipe those smiles off your faces because every building in this town is a flat. This whole friggin' place will be down to the ground. Only this cheap hotel standing up safe and sound. And you'll say, why do they spare that one? That's what you'll say. Why do they spare that one? All the night through, through the noise and to-do, you'll wonder, who is that person that lives up there? And you'll see me stepping out in the morning, looking nice, with a ribbon in my hair. The ship, the black freighter, runs a flag up its mast, and a cheer rings the air. By noon, the dock is swimming with men coming out of that ghostly freighter. They're running in the shadows where no one can see, and they're chaining up the bodies and they're bringing them to me, asking me, kill them now or later. That's what they'll ask. Kill them now or later. Noon by the clock, and so still on the dock, you can hear a foghorn miles away, and in that stillness of death, I say, right now, right now. And as they pile up the bodies, I say, that'll learn ya. And the ship, the black freighter, disappears out to sea, and on it is me.
Like to dedicate to Rita, and then I'm thinking if we were really loud and obnoxious, we could get an encore after that. Yes. I'm going to turn it over to George. Thank you all.
Hi. Thank you, Rita. Thank you, Joan. Thank you, Lisa Murphy, who has been an incredible trooper, one of my best friends in the world. Thank you, my American parents who are here, Gloria and John Mitchell. Gloria is having an exhibit at the McGuffey right now, so go and see it. Sankusem, I'm going to talk about a minute about it. It's an organization that seeks to bring the music of the African village to the concert hall using traditional and classical instruments. And why it's important is because there's this whole untapped reservoir of music from Africa that a few composers have used, but not very many. And this organization I started is called Sankusem, which in Akan, which is an African language, means things about music. It's a not-for-profit in the state of New York. We will get our 501c3 at some point. And we've done some work in Washington State. We teamed up with Seattle Pacific University, talked to students. What's interesting about what we do is it's interdisciplinary. So we had academics, we had musicians, we had dancers, we had drummers, we had violinists. So we had traditional instruments and Western instruments, and academics all arguing about what African music means and what it's trying to do. And we started recording some of the music of some of the composers who are writing African music. So basically, we thought we'd like to come to Charlottesville at some point. And Joan is on our board, Lisa is on our board. We hope Rita will be our friend. And we'd love to do some work with Rita here in the fall of 2013. So I guess we're sort of making our first baby steps in Charlottesville, sort of testing the water, as it were, and hoping to get some friends and people who might help, like talking to us about how to go about this. And since I live in New York, it's really Joan and Lisa who are here, who are kind of helping
us. Lisa's saying it's more Joan than Lisa.
Anyway, so that is Sankusem. That's the reason why we're donating the proceeds to Sankusem is because Rita said she'd like to support this, and Joan kindly offered her apartment for this event. So I want to say a big thank you, and I would like to play a song for Rita. So here you go.
You could say it's a goddess.
Thank you.
Myself yet. Woo! That's pretty good. Thank you, George. Thank you. You know, when George asked if I would do this, and Joan and Lisa, and I knew that I didn't have a lot of time, but the only person who could pull me through would be George, because he's such a consummate musician, and he really was infinitely patient. Well, sometimes impatient. But it's just that anyone who does music knows that you know, you need to just be able to breathe together, and that was what was happening. So I thank him for pushing me farther than I thought I could ever go on very little time, and I just loved hearing play. Two days, that was insane. What were we doing? I mean, okay. So an encore. Let's do this one. Take it down. Do you have an idea? Yeah, that's pretty good. I think that'll work.
Now we can drink.